Good day everyone, Rob Helene from FX Bootcamp with your Asian preview for Wednesday, November the 25th, 2009. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education, it's not an alert service. Coaches are not going to make trade recommendations, however we're going to conduct technical fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans to trade throughout the course of your trading day. Please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged that it's a very risky business. So don't risk your hard-earned money on a live account until you've got a proven track record of success on a demo. Okay, very, very important point, that one, guys. I'm going to continue the theme, guys. It's going to be the last video of the week. It's Thanksgiving. I'm based in the United States with the rest of the bootcamp staff, so it's going to be the last video of the week, so a little heads up there. I want to continue the theme with the pound yen trade, okay, that I started on Monday. We got our pullback. If you remember our video from Monday, we were looking something like this. Okay, and we were after a pullback of the move. And it finally came along. If you go back and look at my previous video, you'll see that I wanted a day of green to get this moving, to find some more sellers in the market, and very much here's our day of green through here, okay, and found some sellers in late New York into Asia yesterday, and down we've come. Okay, so in terms of the way bootcamp likes to trade and its methodologies, it was a perfect setup. If we just go to the a quote board for this GFT quote board, you'll see that here's our high on that 4 hour through here on the 15 minute chart, okay, and we knew that this was multiple levels of resistance off that 4 hour, namely 4 hour 21 weekly central pivot point through here. Love the pivot points, and 50% fib of the move and all that sort of good stuff. So the fact that the 15 minute, and we've been spot trading that north all day, wasn't a great surprise, but once you get into a zone that you'd expect things to roll over, it's best just to take a little bit off the table and see what happens. And in Asia yesterday, we got some lower a new low and a lower high and a new low again, and then right here was the key pullback of the move so far, and it was a perfect 382 to 50% fib of the pullback. And first sign of red, get short this pair. This thing is at 4 hour resistance and 15 minute turning over. A little bit of a clue that the pound yen wanted to come down, and came down quite nicely. And we're just come down to an late New York now while I'm taking this video, and things are just consolidating for a while. Even maybe we're looking to take a fib of this 4 hour move, so something along the lines of this. And if we're going to come down again, well, it's possibly going to head back up to 147, just into the 147s up through here somewhere, and it's going to maybe have another shot. So that's what we're hoping for. I'm hoping for continuation on this pair. Now we know that this pair, just to go back to what we were discussing on Monday, we know this pair is made up of the pound USD and the USD yen combination. And if we just go to those charts and look for where we're going to find the love needed to bring this pound yen down a bit, the pound's not really, by the looks of things, giving us what we need anymore. Okay, we're very much sort of got in a trap. The pound did come, by the way, did come off resistance, just like the pound yen, and the pound was the start of the catalyst to get this pair to come down. Okay, and we were looking at that at bootcamp through our analysis yesterday. But overnight into London and New York today, she's 4 hours starting to look a bit trapped. Okay, so if the pound USD is not going to give us the love we need, well, let's just see what the USD Jappy is going to do. And is there any reasons to continue trying to short this trade? Well, I look at this 4 hour of this USD Jappy, and yes, I think very much so. We've broken through this support overnight, on the 4 hour. And I'm expecting a pullback possibly to the scene of this crime back at 88.71, maybe a tad higher. Okay, and something along the lines of this. And I think this USD yen's got another chance to come down a level. And if it does, the pound yen's gonna to hop on the clue train here, and it's gonna come down with it. Okay, so that's what we're hoping for, and we'll be keeping an eye on that pound as well. And hopefully today on this pound we'll be able to get some bounce off resistance here down this way. USD yen continues its downside, and that's going to be good for our pound yen trade if you're in it. Okay, if you're not in it and the 15 minute rolls over today and it's heading down, just get in a spot trade and spot trade your way and see if you can get something to hold. But definitely I think there's going to be some more opportunities later on the day on this. Now we'll finish the video up with a little profit taking for this. On the 4 hour, I really do like this region here as my next target. We're at 146.75. I think 145.75, 100 pips south of here, is the next target, and that could easily get down there. And the next targets I have for this, let's just go to our weekly pivots. I really like this being achieved here as the next stop for this, down into this 144, 145.50 region. I really think the weekly pivots are going to possibly get hit today, this week on this. So today I'd like to see at least another 100 pip move down, and I think they can easily get that from here even more, and even move down into this 144 region on a good day. Maybe not today, but maybe tomorrow during Thanksgiving, and we'll see where it goes. My ultimate target for this pair, okay, just to wrap this up, is down here on this. This is the weekly 140. Just a reminder, can't help but feel that we're in a downtrend on this pair, and 140 is going to be the next stop. And I'll still have a piece if it gets there. I'll still have pieces in this trade, and while the downtrend wants to keep going, you know, in the new year, into the new year, we could find ourselves quite easily at 130. You never know, but it's worth being in a piece and seeing if it can hold and get yourself a nice long-term trade. Okay, so that's my video, guys. It's a little update on where we're at. For those in the US, have a good Thanksgiving, and we'll see you guys in boot camp on Monday. Okay, cheers, guys. Thanks.